Hey, what's up? This is St. Joe, SoundsandGear.com, back with another review from American Musical Supply, and today we're checking out the Presonus Studio Channel. It's a single channel vacuum tube channel strip. So it's a preamp, it's got an EQ in it, it's got a compressor in it, all that different stuff. Actually, it has an instrument input on the front, as well as your XLR and quarter inch inputs and outputs on the back. So for me, I'm starting to think that American Musical may be watching what I look at on their website or something, because this is the second time they sent a product that specifically I was looking at for myself. So anyway, I just got a new interface, and the preamps on the interface don't really drive my dynamic microphone like I wanted. So my old preamp didn't really work with the interface, and I was looking for a new interface. I mean, I was looking for a new preamp, and this is one of the preamps that I was looking at. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run my mic directly into the interface so you can hear what that sounds like, and then I'm gonna plug it into the studio channel, which I have hooked up already in my rack, and we're just gonna play around with some of the settings just so you can get a feel for what it can do and the different settings and how they affect whatever you're inputting into it. Now for me specifically, I want this for my microphone, but you can use it for instruments or whatever you wanna use it for, synthesizers, whatever, it's up to you. But anyway, let's get into it, see what it sounds like. All right, so now I got my mic plugged directly into my Scarlett interface, and I got the gain on my Scarlett turned all the way up to 10, and it's not distorting, but it's still, it doesn't have the output that I would like. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna unplug it from there, plug the mic directly into the studio channel, then I'm gonna run the studio channel output into my interface. Now when I do that, I can turn the gain down on my interface because the studio channel is gonna be providing my gain. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of go through some of the controls just so you can get a feel for what type of input, output, what type of effect it will have on whatever you're putting through it. For me, it's specifically gonna be vocal, but like I said, you can use it for anything. So let's check that out. All right, so now I'm running through the actual studio channel, and I got that running into my interface. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through and just mess with some of the parameters. You can see I got my tube amp section right here. I got 48 volt phantom power if I need it. I got phase reversal. I got a 20 dB pad, and I got an 80 hertz roll off. I like the 80 hertz roll off because it gets rid of that low level hum and maybe some room noise and stuff that you can pick up when you're using a preamp. You got the compressor right here. And I got a button where I can put the EQ before the compressor, because by default, it comes after the compressor, as you can see. Then also, I got a bypass EQ and a bypass the compressor. Then you got another output gain over here. So I got my gain right here. You can see I can turn it down or I can turn it up, see what I get. Then I got my tube amplification. Now, the funny thing is, I can actually go in and replace the tube if I want to, which is pretty cool. So I don't really use too much of the tube amplification, but here it is turned all the way up, here it is turned down. Now for me and my situation, for some reason, I like to reverse the phase of my input, even though I'm not messing with stereo miking or anything like that. It just, I think it gives me a better sound. So again, it's really up to you. Then you got your compressor. You can see I got my gain right here, got my release, attack, my ratio, my threshold. So I don't really need to mess with that too much, but if I wanted to get more gain out of my compressor, I can turn it up. Or if I wanted to get less, I can turn it down. And I can change my meter, so if I want to see how much gain reduction I'm getting, I can do that as well. So that's pretty cool. Then I also got my EQ. Right now I got my EQ bypassed, but if I want to turn it on, I can go in, turn it on, and then start messing with the different settings. Let's say I want to boost my lows up, I can do that if I want to, which I really normally don't want to. Or if I need it, maybe I need to some gain in my high end, I can do that. So you can see it's pretty flexible. So I'm gonna bypass that again. And then I got my final output. So when I do all my compression and stuff, of course, sometimes when you use a compressor, it can reduce your output. So you got a final stage of gain right here that I can adjust as I need to accordingly. So I can turn that down, as you can see, turning it down, or I can turn it up. So I usually leave it
right about there.
All right, so now you heard the difference between my interface and the studio channel. I personally like the results from the studio channel. Now, keep in mind, what you heard when I was doing the video may not be exactly what I use when I'm using it, but I just wanted to go through all the different settings just to give you a feel for what you can do with the actual channel strip. But overall, man, I give it a 4.5 out of 5. It's a really straightforward preamp, nice channel strip, really nice sound. The price range is really, really good. The one thing I really don't like about it is the knobs, man. Like, it's a personal thing for me. I really don't like notched knobs. I like my knobs to be smooth. I just feel like they feel better, and I feel like I have more control when a knob is smoother. But, you know, some people don't care. I do. I think it's cool that you can actually open it up and change the tube out. So if you're into tubes and getting the different characteristics from different tubes, if that's your thing, that's something you can do with it. So again, for me, I'm using it for my vocals, but you could use this directly for, you know, your guitar or your bass, your synthesizers, EP, whatever you want to use it for. So it's pretty much up to you. But it's your boy St. Joe, SoundsandGear.com, doing another review for American Musical Supply, checking out the Presonus Studio Channel. Let me know what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe. Go check it out on their website. Share this video, all that good stuff. I'll see y'all later. Peace.